I'm going down to Menu, Preferences, and Disks, where it says Manage Drives and Media. This program will give us information about the drives and media, as well as allow us to change things. Please be careful when using this program. It is possible and easy to delete or change something that you did not intend to change or delete. In the upper left-hand corner, we see disks. Clicking that shows us about disks. Clicking that shows us we're in the GNOME Disk Utility 3.10 or the UDisks 2.1.3. Below that, we've got devices. We've got a 250 gigabyte hard drive, a floppy drive that I never use, and a CD/DVD drive. When I click the different devices, we notice the information on the right changes. Going back to the 250 gigabyte hard drive, we see up here on the right, 250 gigabyte hard drive, the model, the size, partitioning, and we've got an assessment. This disk is okay with one bad sector. Currently, it's at 42 degrees Celsius or 108 degrees Fahrenheit. Down below that, we see volumes. We see our hard drive is grouped into two different sections or partitions. This first one is File System Partition 1. And down here, we see it's 90 gigabytes. We see it up here as well, NTFS. We also see the device is DEV for device, SDA1. And then it is contents, NTFS, and it is not mounted. Clicking over here to the other partition, we see this one is 160 gigabytes. It is SDA2. It is a partition type of extended. And then we can click down here for these sub-partitions. SDA5 and SDA6. This is a swap partition. And we already talked about swap partitions. This is just the area where the computer stores the RAM data when the RAM memory starts filling up. The operating system is the other sub-partition. We'll notice that this partition is mounted, whereas this other one is not mounted. If the partition is mounted, that means we can read and write files to it. But if we want to make some changes to the partition itself, we have to unmount it. The Linux partition is mounted because we're using those files right now. If we try and unmount this, and we would unmount it by clicking this square, unmount the file system. It asks us for the password. It tells us that we cannot unmount the file system now because it is in use. And it's in use by us. I just plugged in the flash drive. We see Linux Mint mounts the flash drive, also opens up a file manager window. We saw how to prevent the file manager window from opening in the last video. And we see it's added to our list of devices here, the 2.0 gigabyte drive. Now I want to reformat this flash drive, or maybe repartition it. It already has a partition out there for the entire drive, so I'll need to remove that. Clicking this minus sign will delete the partition. It's asking us, are we sure we want to delete this? All data on this partition will be lost. It's okay, this is empty, so I can delete this. Now it's unmounted, and it's only free space on here. There's no partition. To add a partition, I'm going to click on this plus sign. We can change the partition size. The default is the entire hard drive, 2005 megabytes. Which is the equivalent of 2 gigabytes. I'm going to make this 1 gigabyte or 1000 megabytes. Down below, we've got the file type. We've got FAT, which is compatible with all systems and devices. And FAT stands for File Allocation Table. Then we've got NTFS, which is the new technology file system. These two are recognized by Windows. Then we've got the compatible with Linux EXT4. You also might see EXT2, EXT3. Those are just different version numbers of the extended file system. So 4 is the largest number. It's the most recent. That's the one you would probably choose if you're using an ext file system. We're going to skip these other file system types. I'm going to use FAT because it's compatible with all systems and devices. This erase, don't overwrite the existing data, quick. We can also overwrite the existing data with zeros. If we do the quick, it just tells the file system that those files are deleted, but the files are still out there. If we needed to restore them, we have a good chance of restoring those entire files as long as they're not written over. When we write everything over with zeros, it does a better job of deleting the files that were on that disk. I'm going to do the quick. And I'll give this a name. We'll call this flash drive. And I'll create my partition. There, it's done. It is not mounted because we are just changing the file system. And I've got a gigabyte of free space over here. Clicking on that, I can add a partition. I can make it the whole 1 gigabyte or make that 500 megabytes or anywhere in between. I'm going to leave it at the 1 gigabyte. I'll make this one an ext4. Again, we're going to leave this at quick. And I'll give this the name ext4 and create. Now it's got a partition type of Linux with ext4 is the name. Flash drive is our other partition name. We've got some more tools here that we can edit the partition, edit the file system name. Instead of flash drive, we'll call this thumb drive. Change. It becomes thumb drive. Other things, mounting options, we can tell it to mount right away or not. I'll leave that as the default. Down below, we can create a disk image of this partition or restore from a backup file into this partition. And benchmark, those are some tools to tell you how well your drive is running. Up in the upper right-hand corner, we've got some more tools over here. We can eject the flash drive and we can turn off the power to that flash drive. I am going to remove this partition and remove this other partition and reformat this as a single partition, FAT32, taking up all the space on the drive. We'll give it the name flash drive. Create, and it's reformatted to a single partition as a FAT32 file system. If you like these videos, please tell a friend.